Welcome back. Now, one of the bonuses of being trapped in Europe during a worldwide pandemic is the fact that I get to travel the continent looking for interesting motorcycling stories. And along the way, I often happen to bump into some equally interesting people. The guy we're about to meet is exactly one of these sorts of fellas. He runs a motorcycle workshop with an innovative twist in Dachau, just north of Munich. And I started off by asking Enrico Paoli, who's also a custom bike builder of note, exactly how long his operation has been going.
The workshop exists maybe 3 years ago, but the loose crew are 7 years, 8 years old. At the beginning, we are group of friends, of people, and make whatever we want, and we want to give the bikes and the garage a name, and then we had some brainstorming, and yeah, so in the loose crew brings all us together. It doesn't matter if you want to build a complete custom bike or only to fix some small problems on your bike. So the people can come to us to rent a space. They can come with motorcycles, with bicycles, with something they want to fix it. And so they rent the space, maybe with the lifter and the tools. Also, they can rent only our sandblasting machine, or they can rent some knowledge from me when I have to welding some stuff for there. Otherwise, I can, when they build, maybe they build their motorcycle for their own and they need some knowledge and some help, I'm always in the near, so they can ask me. Or when it's a little bit more intensive, so they can rent me for when I have the time, they can rent me for an hour. And or sometimes the people put their bike here and said, okay, I come back in 2 hours and can you fix these problems. And so it's also work, so it's more a community. So the people come, maybe someone work on their own, and other have a sit on the couch, drink some coffee, and have a look that I work on their bikes. So it works, yeah. So I get my driving license maybe for 7 or 8 years, very late, and it becomes to the driver license because we ride with the motorcycle, with the 50 cubic inch mopeds. We ride from Munich to Gardasee, to Italy. I think we need 3 days, and we go also over the Timmelsjoch and the Jaufenpass with the small bikes, and we ride it with the first gear with maybe 5 kilometers per hour. So the big motorcycles passed us on the ground, and when we came up on the top of the mountain, they sit there, were finished to eat and drink some beer, and they, hey, cool, you arrived, good job, guys. And then they leave us, and we have to drink something and eat and celebrate our long tour to the top. And I think that was the point you saw, okay, maybe when we have bigger cars, we have also fun to go on the top and not only to have fun when we go down to the tail. And then I bought my first bike, XS400, in Munich for 300 euros. And the seller asked me if I want to make a test ride, but I have no license. So I said, no, it's okay, I take it. And he bring it to me from Munich for 300 euros and some beer bottles, and then I start to build it like my own creativity. And maybe 2 months before I finished it, started to become my driver licensed, so that when I finished it, I can ride it. And most time, I cannot say that I'm a motorcycle biker. I think I build more something or repair something on motorcycles than I ride kilometers on the street. And so it's, you finish the bike and it's cool when you ride the bike on the streets. you feel proud because you have this bike completely built it up for you by your own with many problems and many ideas that at the first time it doesn't work, so you have to make it again and again, and then it works. And so it makes you proud, and when there come maybe one guy of 100 give you thumbs up, you think, okay, cool, there's another idiot who like my bikes there. And yeah, so yeah, and then when this one's finished, you have to, or while you build this bike, you have another ideas, and you said, okay, maybe this can work on the next project. And then yeah, so they come idea from the one project to the next project. And most of my bikes I build it for my own, and it's not so easy to sell them because it's very special, and you cannot and your heart is in the bike. And it's so, maybe when one guy came and put me a full bag of money and said, okay, I take it, maybe then I have to think about it. But at some points you said, okay, no, I built you your own bike. You said, okay, you want it, I build it, but not this bike. The only bike I have who has a name was my first bike, but it was more like I have on the exhaust, because the bike have many skateboard parts on it, and on the exhaust there was the SK8, like skate, and some of my friends are not involved in this skate scene, and he asked me what it called Skacht, like SK8, like the German 8. And so maybe we call this bike Skacht, but that's the only bike who has a name. The other bikes are, yeah, maybe they don't need names. They hopefully they speak for themselves, and yeah. We have a BSA 810 from 1956. I bought it like it was a barn find. It doesn't run, and yeah, we put in with us, and then okay, we put everything what we don't need, what I don't need, off, and yeah, just build it like I want it. And from, I don't make any skizzes of a bike at the beginning. I have some ideas, then I try it, and then it grows up and grows up. So you have to, okay, we fit the, at the beginning there was another fuel tank on it, but then I take this, I become this, and I put it on, okay, it's perfect for this bike. And then it goes bigger, okay, we make this on the disc plate for the rear wheels on it, okay, and then the fender maybe with a little sissy bar and the bicycle light on it. And so most of the things I found on the flea market, and then I hold it on the bike, and okay, maybe this can work, and then you have to try it. And yeah, it's sometimes not so easy to put things on it you want to put on it, because yeah, it's not work so easy in it. So you have to thinking about it, how it can work and how we can make it on it. And yeah, I have a little bit, I knew what I want to, but I'm not on a straight line. I can go, sometimes I go a little bit left and sometimes I go a little bit right. So it's not that I see this bike and I knew, okay, at the end it looks like this. I like it that the bike grows with the project. Every bike I build for my own, I ride it, because otherwise it makes no sense to build a bike only to show it. Maybe it's not shiny, it's leaking oil here and crappy there, but yeah, it works, yeah. I chop the forks in front and on the left and make a 20-inch front wheel on it, yeah. with a duplex brake. So it works better than the original brake, but it doesn't break, it's more like you're getting slower before you crashed it in something like and yeah, it's the lowest, the weight is very low, so you can handle it like a bicycle, and it makes really fun. It's a very big part of my life. Yeah, most time, yeah. When I don't fix some problems on my bikes when I want to ride, I'm happy, yeah.